So welcome to all. I'm Dr. Raghumar, currently associated with the Dr. NGP Institute of Technology as professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering. So today we will discuss or we will see about an important topic called as fixed limits and tolerance. That is most importantly needed for all the engineering students who are studying, because they are going for an industry. This is most important need, and they should know something fundamental about the three terms: fixed limits and tolerance. So these three things comes into contact when you are going for a melting counter. That is when you are melting a shaft with a cylinder or something like that, where you are melting a hole and a shaft or hole and a cylinder. So when you are having the coming across, you have two things. When you have the shaft, or it will be in the shape of a cylinder, and the other thing, you have a hole. These parts has to be fit into each other, or these two components have to be melted into each other for getting a proper result. So if these two components are not aligned properly, then obviously there will be having a lot of problems with respect to the mating, with respect to the output. So you have some kind of defects like vibration, or you have some chattering or something like that. So these two things has to be handled properly. The shaft and the hole has to be handled properly while assembling. So coming across this, you have different terminologies. The first one is the diameter. Then the deviations, the upper limit or the lower limit, then we will see across the tolerance and the limits. So in the case of a shaft, we have two things. One is the maximum diameter allowable, or that is a maximum limit, and the shaft will have the minimum diameter, that is the minimum permissible limit. And when you come across the hole, you have the basic size, and there is a minimum diameter of the hole required, and there is a maximum diameter of the hole required. And tolerance is normally the difference between your maximum diameter and the maximum diameter and the minimum diameter of the base. You can call it as the difference between the lower deviation or the lower limit and your upper limit. And that is the case in the case of your hole also. Tolerance is the difference between the maximum and minimum dimensions of a component, that is between your upper limit and lower limit. And again, coming to the tolerance, normally you have two types of tolerance. One is called as your unilateral tolerance, and another one is called as your bilateral tolerance. Unilateral tolerance is, you have the tolerance deviation across your only one direction, either maybe in the positive direction or it may be in your negative direction. Whereas when you come across a bilateral tolerance, you have the tolerance across the two things, one is your positive direction and as well as your negative direction. Positive direction means it is the dimension which is above the baseline, and negative dimension means the dimension which is below your basic. And allowance is the dimension between the two mating points, that is the deviation in between your upper and lower component. And when you are coming to fits, the fits are normally the manufacturing part that require the components to mate each other when you are going for an assembly. The relation between the two mating parts may plays a vital role with respect to the difference in dimensions between the assembly, that you call it as fit. That is a gap in between, or the overlapping in between the two components, we call it as a fit. Therefore, an ideal fit is always required for a proper functioning of the material. So coming to fit, you have normally three types of fit. One is your clearance fit, the transition fit, and your interference. In case of the clearance fit, the maximum diameter of the shaft will be less than the minimum diameter of the hole. So maximum diameter of the shaft will be less than the minimum diameter of the hole. Therefore, always there will be a gap in between the shaft and the hole. So this type of fit will always have some clearance in between your hole and shaft. That is what you call it as the clearance fit, or in colloquial language you call it as the loose fit. And second one will be your transition fit. The transition fit, always the maximum diameter of the shaft will be greater than the minimum diameter of the hole. So there will be some amount of overlapping in between your shaft and the hole. So these two things, the transition fit, their dimensions can be adjusted so that the hole and shaft can be mated each other. And the third one is quite complicated. There, in this case, the minimum diameter of the shaft will be greater than the maximum diameter of the hole. That is what we call it as interference fit, where you have a very tight movement between the shaft and the hole. It is quite possible to mate the shaft and hole in this case. Therefore, you have to make some modification either into the shaft or into the hole to have a proper fit. So these are the basic fundamentals about the fit. Thank you.